So you start with net income, first one, plus non-cash charges, plus minus working capital investment, plus interest net of taxes, plus minus fixed capital investment. This is your first metric. Now these three numbers are same as the CFO. So that's your second formula. So CFO plus interest 1 minus T plus minus fixed capital investment. Then one formula that starts with EBIT, we multiply that with 1 minus T. Now this number is same as net income plus interest into 1 minus T. So it is also called as NOPAT, net operating profit after taxes. Then once you have taken care of these two items by this one single metric, you just plot the remaining stuff. So plus NCC plus minus working capital investment plus minus fixed capital investment. Then next metric is EBITDA. So EBITDA into 1 minus T plus depreciation into T. Now these two numbers are same as the total of these two numbers, and you do the remaining ones then. So plus minus working capital investment plus minus fixed capital investments. These are your four formulas. We'll do an interesting numerical. We are trying to build a very broad view on FCFF and FCFE metrics, right? And we want to kind of understand intuition on how they work. So I'm building a simplified example here. A simple case where two people come together, and let's say the first guy is equity shareholder, second one is bondholder. Both of them put in 500 each. Now using that 1000, they decide to buy a series of cars. So they bought multiple cars. Then using those cars, they got into a car rental business. Now the business is like this, just to keep it a pure play, simple calculation. This company will have an agreement with one of the clients, and these cars would be leased out to them for a window of 5 years. And for every year, you can expect to receive a cash flow of 600 from the client. And at the end of 5 years, the cars would be passed on to the owners, right? Just to keep our calculation simple. So you've got into this business, you have a series of cars, all these cars have been leased out, and they have been leased out to this particular company, which every year is going to pay how much? 600. And at the end of 5 years, they're going to keep the cars. So your business gets shut down that year. Are we okay? So straightforward case. Now for simplicity, I'm going to keep my cost of equity and debt as same. So cost of equity 10%, cost of debt 10%. Ideally, we know that cost of debt should be lower than cost of equity. We're doing this so that our calculations are little, this is more of an indicative model. So calculations are simple. Now this cash which is generated, is it generated by my operating assets? So if I want to value my operating assets, I can just take present value of this cash. So these numbers that you see, you think of them as FCFF. That's what FCFF is. What is the free cash that my entire business is going to generate? And this FCFF, we have to discount by WACC. And what do you get then? You get value of the entire firm. And once you have the valuation of firm, you can always figure out what should be the valuation of equity. Now, in this case, what do you think would be your WACC? It would be 10, because the cost of equity and cost of debt is same. So weights don't matter. So that's 10%. So let's do it super fast. Use your calculators. Can we handle this on the TVM row? Because it's a simple annuity. So second clear TVM. 600 should be your payment. Is that correct? 600 payment. How many payments? 5. So 5 is N. 10 is IY. Compute present value. Sorry, how much? 2274. So 2274 is the valuation of the entire firm. 2274 is the valuation of entire firm. Entire firm means it is the value that's available for both of these guys. 2274 is the valuation, the market value. Now, what is the valuation of the equity shareholder? So we will say value of equity 2274 minus 500. And that's the whole beauty of it. that equity shareholder gets to keep the entire upside on valuation. Nothing goes to bondholders. Because bondholders decided not to take any risk, he does not also get the rewards. So you just pay him 500 if you decide to, and then the valuation of your equity is 1774. This is the equity valuation metric using FCFF numbers. So you forecast FCFF. Now, when you're dealing with real life companies, that's a complicated task, right? This was a simplistic case, but you forecast FCFF for future, then you discount FCFF with WACC, and then you get what? Valuation of the entire operating assets, which is same as value of firm. And then value of firm minus value of debt, and then you're left with value of equity. Another way of doing it. Again, I'll give you time, but just focus. FCFF is 600 for each of the 5 years. This is the money that's available for both of these guys, equity and bond. What you decided is that to the bond guy, every year you'll start paying him an installment. And over the window of these 5 years, every year you'll pay him some installment and some interest in such a way that his loan is over. Is that doable? Can we figure out how much we should pay to the bondholder to clear off his loan? How will you do it? Again, the TVM row. So you will say second clear TVM. Tell me now how to handle this question. What should be your present value? 500. So 500 is your present value, right? Because that's the loan I've taken today. Then 10 would be your IY. 5 would be your N. And then we will compute the payment. So compute payment. That's like your installment. How much? 131. Right. So 131.9. So let's call it 132. So every year I pay the bondholder guy 132. Is he happy? Yes, because he gets his principal back, he gets to earn interest on that, right? So now the bondholder person is gone. Now the money that's left with us, that money is for whom? It's for equity shareholder. So again, observe, what did we really deduct here? We deducted two items. We removed interest and we removed principal repayment. That was your formula of FCFE. You start with FCFF, because you've added interest, you remove interest. So minus interest, 1 minus 3. Here we are not assuming taxes. And then you remove the borrowing. And then you are left with FCFE here. And FCFE is the cash which is entirely available to equity shareholder. So let's find out how much that turns out to be. So that's 468. And this FCFE, we should discount at cost of equity. And cost of equity is how much? 10%. And when you discount FCFE with cost of equity, what do you get? Value of equity directly this time, not the value of firm. So let's do it. Second clear TVM, 468 payment, 5N, 10IY, compute present value, 1774. And your valuation is? Same with either of the two approaches. It should be same, right? So this is what you need to remember for the exams now, CFA level 1. You need to remember the formulas of FCFF and FCFE. Will you remember that? Then you need to know that FCFF we discount with WACC, WACC. And when you discount FCFF with WACC, what do you get? Value of the entire firm. And value of firm minus value of debt, what do you get? Value of equity. Alternatively, you calculate FCFE, which is a cash flow available only for equity shareholder. And then FCFE you discount at what rate? Cost of equity. And then what do you get? Value of equity directly. So if I divide this with number of shares, then I would get a sense of what is the valuation of the business. Are we okay?